and sit in there. You got the questions there.
Mr. Ben, was you saved at Mount Tabor, or where was you saved?
At Mount Tabor.
Where was you baptized?
Blue hole.
Everywhere we went, it's been blue hole. Who was the preacher? Who done the preaching? You remember the preacher?
Hell, my boy.
Was there a revival?
Matt Christ was a revival.
Matt Christ.
He was an evangelist.
Revival.
Mm-hmm. About what year was that? Remember?
Huh?
What year was that?
I don't remember. Yet.
Back in the 20s or 30s?
No, it was in the 40s.
40s?
It was in about 41 or 2, somewhere along the
way. Somewhere in the first parts of 40.
Well, do you remember anything your grandparents told you about Tabor? Do you mean anything at all?
No, I don't.
Are you mother, dad, or anybody?
What about when the church set out here by Miss Annie's? Remember anything about anybody ever tell you anything about the church before it was moved?
No.
It's hard to find any information back in those days.
What would you say?
Mount Tabor. Same time we were.
Really?
Same. So it had to be Blue Hole too.
There was a whole bunch of us that year. I can't remember just how many. I met Ruth L. They had Bellevue baptized me with hers. Ruth L., Brother Marsh's sister was in. I reckon he must have been pastor there too at that time.
Oh, did they have preaching once a month?
Brother Sears told us last night that Brother Morris preached back in 43. He had four churches. They just one
for
Sunday.
For time, I believe he called.
It was Tabor, Cedar Grove, and he didn't mention other two, so Bellevue might have been one of them.
I believe it was. Mm-hmm. I believe he was preaching there.
Well, it could have been Britt Mark, Ebenezer, because I think he was in both of those places.
Mm-hmm.
How'd y'all go to church back in those days?
My wagon, team.
Did you live back in here? Or?
Lived up yonder at that old yellow house where it's falling down now. That old
okay,
house.
The one was Esther about. Mm-hmm.
Right on the side of the road. Mm-hmm. Now we just lived there and down here since we've been married. Well, there's another house right there by it. We lived there a couple of years before we moved out to ourselves.
Yeah, about 7 years and I haven't been down there.
Well, did Uncle Bob and Aunt Severy, was they members at Tabor or mm-hmm. you members?
She was, I know.
They never did have any pictures of any kind, did they? Of the old mm-hmm. church?
No. Your mom and daddy, they was both?
Well, yes, they were both. Nobody else.
Well, this is a question we usually ask everybody. What'd you do for recreation, you know, after church or Sunday evenings? I know you didn't have television to watch, so what did you do?
Well, most time we just stay at home and let the kids play or somebody come in or maybe we'd go to somebody's house. I know a lot of times. Well, not a lot, but several times we'd go down and dunk a baby.
I remember that when all the kids would come in.
Mm-hmm. Yeah, we'd go down there more so than anywhere else.
Y'all remember being down there one Sunday evening with Jane, Gladys, with all, I don't know how many kids, we were probably 15 or 20, was going to Easter egg hunt and come 6-inch snow. We couldn't hide eggs.
Good gracious.
I don't remember
Easter Sunday.
remember
that
having
was probably March, being that much snow.
Yeah, it was 29th of March.
No, I don't guess we was over there then.
Might have been too much snow.
I guess it was. Well, you know, when it's real cold, you couldn't go very far riding in the wagon, especially if you had little kids.
Wouldn't have a picture of you in your wagon, would you?
No, we never did take pictures back then.
Very few people could afford a camera back
right.
in those days.
Done well to have a wagon to ride in.
Was there anything that really stands out in your mind about Mount Tabor?
Just a lot of people went with mules and wagon, and I can remember Mr. Gaither Pole and them, they always come in their wagon. They did, though, after other people got to come in cars. Well, they'd still come in their wagon. I reckon, did he ever even drive a car?
Did he?
Don't remember him.
I don't remember him ever having a car.
I don't remember him.
What about Miss Dorothy and Miss Sally? I know you.
Well, I can remember them. I remember Aunt Ollie shouting and having a big time. She'd really make everybody happy.
Y'all remember the time he backed off in the well?
No.
One fella was telling us about the time he backed off in the well out there.
Well, Slack was telling us he got this car. This is when cars first come out.
Yeah.
Him and Miss Ollie got in this car and back had a hand dug well somewhere back at a church or somewhere down in there. And they got in and was backing out. And back in, I dropped off in that well. A bunch of them had to pick it up and set it out.
Association dinners up there. That's been a long time ago since we had one of them, haven't
you? I can remember '43 when they had the 100th anniversary. Brother Sears tells us about that. They had the, that's when association meetings lasted 3 days.
Yeah.
And had a dinner and association meeting and the 100th anniversary all at the same time. In the back of my mind, I can see a whole bunch of people, but I can't see anybody that I know.
Yeah. Well, I can remember them, but I can't remember whether I was there that particular one you're talking about or not.
Well, do you remember anybody that had any influence on you, or the most influence on you?
I guess it's Miss Ruby Hightower. She would come and talk to me.
What's the first preacher that you can remember? Pastor out there.
Brother Marsh is the first thing I can remember.
Sure.
Mm-hmm. I reckon that's when we started going. He was a pastor.
They say there was a couple before him. Of course, that was before my day.
Yeah.
That may have been before you started going, too.
I guess it was. Because I can't remember him. What year did Bill Marsh start preaching?
37.
Well, that's the next year after we got married.
He left in 51. He was there 14 years.
Younger generation now concerning church. they're going to church regular and, listen to the older people, they put you on the right path. Most of them that go to church all the time.
Brother Sears said something last night I never heard before. He said the young people helps keep the old people from drying up, and the older people helps keep the young people from growing up.
I guess I never heard that before.
I guess that makes sense, you think about it.
I think we've got a bunch of good young folks in our church.
That's what he said. He said about it, probably many more young people come up here than any other church that he knows of.
Do you have a sermon or a song or anything that stands out in your mind?
No, I can't seem to do it.
Baptizing?
More so than the rest.
Can you remember any organ players or song leaders back in the younger days? Who was a song leader? Organs? They didn't have a piano until the early 50s. Who was a song leader or organ player that you can remember?
Mr. Lawrence Hightower, I guess, is an organ player.
I can't remember. I would remember him.
Yeah, you should.
I remember Mr. Lucian leading the singing for a long time. But I think Freeman was playing I can't remember the organ, really. That was just one of them things that didn't, stick to my mind.
Yeah. Well, the organ didn't stick in my mind. It seemed to me like it had been a piano all the time, but maybe it was
piano.
Geneva's got the first piano now, there in the trailer.
Mm-hmm.
About it, I think, in the early 50s.
51 or 2, I think, so. Got the piano.
I can remember one time when Lucille's, Miss Eddie's sister, what's her name?
Georgie?
Yeah. George and Lucille was fussing at one another, and each one was wanting the other one to play. And Lucille had a Geneva, to take care of. Georgia told her she could take care of that baby just as well as she could, for her to go on and play. I don't remember which one ever played.
But there's already over there.
Yeah.
You don't remember Lucille playing a guitar, do you?
Uh-uh.
I don't think she ever played at church. She just played out.
That was Miss Bertha talking about that.
Miss Bertha Tucker sung and Lucille played the guitar. And somebody
come up and they quit.
That's when they moved out here to Miss Mindy Deason place.
Yeah.
And somebody come up and heard them singing, wanna know who was that. Said they're doing some mighty fine playing singing. That was when Lucille and Bertha were just I guess maybe teenagers, I don't know. She didn't say how old they were, but when they was growing up.
One of the questions was what was going to church like during the Depression years?
Some of them call it good old days,
Well, we might call it good old days, but it's a lot easier to go now than it was then. One thing going is like going anywhere else. I mean, you didn't have no money to worry about. You didn't have much money to give the preacher. I don't see how they got along.
Well, no, they told us, I believe it was Wallace, told us that whoever the pastor was walked from Lewisburg, had to start Saturday, walked from Lewisburg to Tabor, and he got 60 cents a month.
Hmm.
Of course, he probably didn't preach over once or twice a month. Might have been one time a month. We got 60 cents walking that distance.
Well, they used to pay the preachers in vegetables and things, a lot of
chickens and meat, that's what Brother Sears said last night. Can you remember the year that they had a revival, and I believe Brother Morris and Brother Rice got food poisoning, got sick, and they both got sick the same night, and had to quit preaching. One would preach, and the other would fill in for him. Then they both got sick.
No,
on some
I guess
tea
we weren't
or something.
There that night.
You don't remember that? I can remember that.
Yeah, I guess we weren't there that
Brother
night.
Brother Sears said he could remember that, so he must have. Whether he was there that night or during that week or 2 weeks, it about been lasted 2 or 3 weeks. Is there any more questions on that?
No, we're covered.
Can you think of anything that we hadn't mentioned that
you might want
to
add?
To mind?
No, I can't think of anything.
It's called back about 60 or 70 years. And you're just little toeheads running around.
70 years ago, I wasn't doing much running.
Crawling, then.
No, I wasn't even crawling.
Wasn't even crawling?
No. I was just 70 in December. Well, I guess I was crawling 70 years ago.
No.
Mm-hmm. Ben might have remembered something, I don't know, but I can't remember that far back.
Do you know what they call the Tucker Ridge? Do you know if that's the road that when we turn the top of the hill up there at Mary Rutherford's and come down this way, that other road that goes back?
Yeah, that goes on the Tucker Ridge.
Is that what they call it?
That is Tucker Ridge.
They said the church was originally there.
Really?
The first time. Then it was moved out to where, pretty close there, to where Elry lives. Mm. Then where it's at now.
It's on its third site now.
It moved from there, Miss Annie's Elvis, towards that now in 1908.
We're just wondering how much of a building is still old, how much in there is still part of the old original, even.
They say all the framing is still there.
Because the book just said that the old, was a log structure. Mm-hmm. That's all it gave on it in the minutes. A log structure located on Turkey Ridge. And it was moved out there and to the other part, and then moved from there towards that now in 1909, something like that. Dedicated, I think, about 1910.
We don't know how long it stayed at the first place on Tucker Ridge till it moved out there by Elvis.
Or how long it was. Well, we know it moved from 1908 out towards that now.
So we don't know if it was established in 43 on Tucker Ridge. Then we don't know what year it was moved at that Elvis. Mm-hmm. We started about 50 years too late trying to find out stuff.
Mm-hmm. You know, one year at the homecoming, Brother Morris gave what history of it he had.
Yeah, what he called a roll call. I've got that on tape. I taped that and I made a cassette of it. The preacher's got it. He's going to get one of these machines that will run off a 60 or 90 minute tape in about 30 seconds. He's going to make a bunch and give one to each family on what Brother Morris called the roll call. And he goes back as far as he can remember. And he mentions the four families that he knows of that, kind of started out the church. Of course, the Mitchells and Deasons, that's two kind of my mind he mentioned. It's been 2 or 3 years since I listened to that tape.
Well, see, that time he was there doing that, that was before we got the fellowship hall built, wasn't it?
Mm-hmm. That was in 83, I think, when he was there. I believe that's what's on the date on the tape, 83. August 83. I recorded on one of them big reel to reel. Then I put it back, changed it over to cassette. come to Cedar Grove either next Sunday or Sunday after that and have a roll call, see some roll call for Cedar Grove. Because I borrowed the tape and listened to it, of course. That didn't mean much to me because I didn't know, you know, any of the people that established Cedar Grove. Anything else come to your mind?
I can't think of anything else.
Can you remember the first car that... That was probably for your day too, the first car that was there.
Yeah, that's for my time. I'm sure there was some there because we had an old car. See, I was raised in Drexburg. I was 11 years old when we moved up here in this part of the country.
Mm-hmm.
The old car in that can wasn't too much.
No.
Well, the daddy had one. He drove it back and forth to Drexburg work. He'd go down there and stay a week at a time. He didn't go drive every day, but he'd go down there and stay a week at a time working the mines.
Coal mine.
Uh-huh. Bought this old farm over here and moved us up here, and then he'd go back down there and work. I don't know what he'd done it for.
It wouldn't last a month. I don't guess if she did it every day.
Told us more than you know now,
didn't
you?
Yeah. Yeah, I never didn't know much. You like me whenever somebody asks you questions, you just go blank.
Yeah.
That's the way I
just go blank.
And I can remember we'd go to church of the night in the wagon and we'd stop and pick up Mabel and Raymond. They lived out there in the cabin. Going to church then. Later on down the line, and we still just going in wagon.
Use the lantern?
No. Don't use it, don't their way. I mean, we didn't have no lantern.
They could see in the dark.
Yeah, they could see in the dark, I guess.
Just told them where he was going, they'd take you.
Yeah.
We'd walk out of home.
Yeah, especially coming back home.
We'd all walk out of the
house.
Walk by the lantern.
Yeah. Well, we walked some before we got the kids, then when we got them, we couldn't carry them very well, that far.
Used to be a lot of fox fire. Mm-hmm. You know, that phosphorus, what it is, it glows on oak trees. Yeah. We'd walk up from the hollow, going up through there, where Lucille is now, Richard Reeder. There was one particular place down through there that foxfire would show up more than anywhere else. It's just funny how some things stand out in your mind back over 45, 50 years.
Yeah.
Yes, I have seen.
It favored something like a lightning bug sitting on it down pretty close to the ground. You didn't see it way up, it was just down a foot or so of the ground. Maybe where the roots come out top of the ground, mm-hmm. Be long in there.
see him something else.